¡Diablo!
¡Diablo! ¡Diablo! ¡Diablo! ¡Diablo! ¡Diablo! ¡Diablo!
Hi, I'm Yeri Batista, and I just started my journey playing Bomb Crypto. I got very lucky and have 1 legend, 4 super rare, and 2 rare. In addition, I have selected the best ones from the common level and will upgrade them, sacrificing the ones with lower levels or abilities, so the purpose of this video is to teach you which abilities to take into account before upgrading a hero. Bomb Crypto play to earn game comes from Bomberman, also briefly known as Dyna Blaster in Europe. Is also known as Bakudan Otoko and was released in Japan in July 1983 and has since spawned multiple sequels and spin-offs released on numerous platforms, as well as several anime and manga adaptations. The first and most important ability is speed. Each hero will choose a block or chest to attack. If the hero is very slow, it will take a long time to arrive, and maybe another hero will place a bomb or the target will be destroyed. Then the hero will need to find another target and so on. It is very unlikely for those heroes to place bombs while faster heroes are active. The number goes from 1 to 18 and indicates the numbers of blocks the hero can move per second. The second and the only ability you can upgrade is power. The number goes from 1 to 18 and indicates how strong is the explosion. This ability can be upgraded by sacrificing a hero of the same level, so you can upgrade a hero you use often with other that you don't use. Note, it is mostly recommended and you have more than 15 heroes, which is the maximum can be active at a given time. Next is stamina, which indicates the number of bombs a hero can carry. The number goes from 1 to 15 and each represents 50 bombs, so if your hero has 2, it can carry 100 bombs, 3 for 150 bombs, and so on. When heroes run out stamina, the heroes will enter in sleep mode and this energy will recharge at a rate of 0.5 per minute. Common heroes can place just 1 bomb at a target and have to wait till it explodes to place another bomb. Bomb number goes from 1 to 6 and represents the number of bombs a hero can place in the map at the same time. A hero with greater bomb number can place up to 4 bombs at a target on each side and choose other targets to attack. The heroes will place all bombs in a sequence and then wait for all of them to explode before starting again. The last ability is bomb range, which goes from 1 to 6, and indicate the area the explosion will expand and hit other targets. Each number represents 1 block, so the explosion can take from 1 to 6 blocks. Knowing all this, you should never keep a hero with a speed less than 3 and a stamina of 1, because it will only carry 50 bombs and will be too slow. Is very unlikely for a common hero that bomb number and bomb range will be greater than 1. A stamina of 2 is good, but 3 or more is preferred. Finally, we have skills, which define how the heroes will attack, some damage bonus, and most importantly if they will recharge faster or save energy. You should prefer fast charge skill first and save battery second. Fast charge will allow a hero to charge faster at 0.5 rate per minute, and with the save battery skill there's a 20% chance that the hero will not lose energy when placing a bomb, meaning the hero can place more bombs. The other skills like prison break, pierce block, bomb pass, block pass and treasure hunter are a plus. So when planning to upgrade your heroes, take this into account. You can choose a low power hero with fast charging, save battery and good speed. Bomb power can be obtained by upgrading, so a common hero can be as powerful or more than a rare. If you liked this video, let me know in the comments, maybe I will make a full user guide to this game.